Good evening. A man is in a critical condition in hospital this evening after an assault in Stockton last night. Officers were called to Ivy House on Dovecot Street in the town centre at around 10 to 12 after reports of a fight. A 28-year-old man was taken to hospital with serious head injuries. A 35-year-old man has been arrested on suspicion of assault. On Boxing Day in 2015, a grandmother from Northumberland left her home in Ponteland and was never seen alive again. Sally Allen's body was later found in the River Tyne. Her family believe she'd been suffering from mental health issues which had been hidden from them. Today, to mark what would have been their 40th wedding anniversary, her husband Gordon completed a triathlon to raise awareness about the issue. Johnny Blair reports.
Across the road from the church where he was married, Gordon Allen and his supporters begin 12 miles of cycling. The swimming is done. After comes the walking. Three pastimes he and his wife enjoyed together.
I'm doing it to celebrate my 40th wedding anniversary. I guess my approach since I lost Sally is to sort of try and turn these milestone anniversaries into sort of a positive memory. We had started talking about our 40th wedding anniversary and, you know, I guess we might have been on a holiday to Vietnam or, you know, camper vanning in Scotland or something. So it's not exactly as it was planned, but, you know, it is really nice to think, you know, that, you know, Sally's still out there helping people. That's the way, I guess, that I get comfort, I think.
What's the spirit like among the team here?
Oh, very good. Yeah, very good. Very enthusiastic and positive. Taking part in a triathlon is a fantastic way to, obviously, if you're suffering from mental health, exercise and getting out in the fresh air, meeting people, it's all kind of very positive things to help you with any mental health issues that you've got out there.
Sally hadn't told her family she was unwell. Since her death, they have campaigned to raise awareness of the issue. Money made from the triathlon will go to the mental health charity Mind, as well as the Sally Allen Fund, to help deliver presentations.
Sally spent her life helping others. I mean, she did that too much. She didn't take care of herself. And that's one of the things about mental health is at times you do have to be selfish. But Sally loved helping other people. And therefore, yeah, what better legacy than to sort of use her name and her story to go around and help others.
It's a legacy being kept alive in many different ways on a day of huge significance. Johnny Blair, ITV News, Ponteland.
A memorial service has taken place at the site of the former Middleton St George Air Base on Teesside, marking the efforts of the RAF and the Royal Canadian Air Force there during the Second World War. Among those attending, 94-year-old former Flight Lieutenant Arthur Barrett from Canada, who says he'll never forget his time in the UK.
I went from being a boy to being a man overnight.
In this part of the world?
Yeah, this is my third year, probably be my last, you know.
You had to be here today.
Had to be.
Over 30,000 dogs and their owners have taken to the South Shields coastline for the Great North Dog Walk. The three-mile event holds the world record for the biggest dog walk. Organisers hope it can one day be as big as the Great North Run.
Me in 1990, I started with 12 of my school kids and myself, 13 in 1990. Last year, 30,114 dogs, 45,000 people. It's unbelievable. It's fantastic. It's phenomenal.
The dog's part of the family, so we kind of like, we're like that. There's loads of other people who like that as well.
It's nice to see other dogs and dogs trust which we support.
Bella and Daisy, they're both English setters. They're rescue dogs. So for us to be able to come here and spend some time with them, weather's not great, but so what? The dogs don't mind.
Finally, Northeast comedian Lee Ridley, known as the Lost Voice Guy, is the bookies' favourite to win Britain's Got Talent later tonight. Lee, who's from Concert, was the first act to get through to the final after a public vote on Monday. Good luck to Lee. That's it from me. Kerry's got the weather next, but from all the weekend team, enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Bye-bye.
Sponsors ITV Tyne Tees Weather. Hello, good evening. We struggle with cloud amounts across the region today. Even in Northumberland, a few showery outbreaks continuing into the afternoon and evening. There will definitely be some sunshine in the mix over the coming few days, but certainly out towards the coast tomorrow, remaining fairly cloudy with mist and murk developing once more overnight tonight and transferring westward. So a fairly cloudy picture all in all. There could be some heavy showers, maybe even a rumble or two of thunder during the course of the night, and that mist and murk lingering along the coastline as we head towards dawn. It's fairly muggy one as well overnight tonight, and that misty low cloud will really struggle to clear once more directly at the coast. A few brighter spells inland, and where we get the brighter spells, the temperatures will start to lift. But overall, it's a cooler and breezier day tomorrow, but a lot of dry weather to come over the next few days.
TUI sponsors ITV Tyne-Tees Weather. Live vividly this summer with the ITV Pollen Count, sponsored by Pyrenees Hay Fever Relief Nasal Spray.
Over the next few days, grass pollen counts, certainly down towards parts of North Yorkshire, will be moderate to high. Elsewhere inland, moderate, always a little lower directly at the coast. So head there for the lowest of the grass pollen counts.